What's going on, guys? I am Pranav from Zoomfa, and today we're going to review two pens and then compare it. Then we're going to see which pen is dope or which one is nope. So let's check it out. So first we have the Rotor Climatic. It's a ball pen. It's 75 rupees. So this is 75 rupees. It looks cool. It comes in this packaging, which is pretty cool. So we're going to unbox this. And then we have the Parker Beta Special Edition. So roller pen. We have a refill too. So we're gonna unbox this. So this is 170 rupees and this is 75 rupees. It's like almost a difference of 100 rupees. So let's check it out. So first we're gonna go with the 75 one as it's low price, so okay, that is a pretty good package. See, then you get this box, so you don't need that. And then, okay, this is pretty good packaging. Get it in the box. Oh, that smells. So I'm just gonna take it out. Hold on, take this thing out. Yeah, so here we have the Gomatic. It's pretty shiny. It says Rotor here. It's like a navy blue colors here, and shiny silver metallic. It feels pretty great. If you want to keep it in your pocket, it's pretty good. Oh, see this. It's like a normal pen. The nib, the grip is pretty soft. It's a cool nib. Okay, we're gonna check the review. Not spring loaded. So this is the Rotor Jet Metal Refill. It's pretty cool. Looks pretty cool. Now we just have to test it out. So let's just take our Liberty's book and write something and check it out. So guys, this writes pretty smooth. This writes pretty smooth. I'm telling you, this is pretty good. For 75 rupees, this is worth it. And this is dope, but we're gonna compare it. So let's just keep this aside. This, we're gonna check out the Parker Beta. In front of you, we have the Parker. So this is pretty good pen. That's pretty good design. Not like the normal Parkers. Yeah, normal Parkers. So we're just gonna unbox it right here. Oh, that didn't even open. I need that. Just gonna. Sure. Okay. Yo, that is pretty good design. So, they get a navigator, technology, robot, refill. That's pretty cool that they include a refill. That's pretty good actually. And now finally we have pen. So let me see. Whoa. What? I thought they give an extra refill. That's bad. This is just a Parker without a refill. Extra refill. I thought there would be an extra refill. It's okay. Just gonna. So in the refill, they give the water. Just a second, guys. I'm just gonna put it properly and come. So they give the nib covered. So you just need to take out the cover and then just to the sword and then cap it on. This design is pretty good than this, but I don't know how it writes, so let's check it out. So guys, this pen writes pretty cool, the Parker. So now we're on to the comparison. So we had to compare these two pens. So guys, have the two pens here. So we're gonna compare three things. So first, the design. Second, the ability to write. Third, everywhere use. So we're gonna take it out. So if we go with the design, I think I like this. This looks cool, but I like this. And this has a pretty cool metallic feel. It's metal, but it's a metallic feel, and it's like a, it's coming down like this. It's fat here, and it's just going down, and this looks pretty cool. And if you have it in your pocket, it looks pretty cool actually. And then if you go to this, the design, like some more triangles. So you can buy this, but it's not so attractive like this as shines, no? Yeah. So in the design test, this one. So guys, comment down below if you feel this or this, it has a good design. No, some of you might feel, no, this doesn't have, this has a good design. So you guys comment down below so that I can see what you think. Okay, let's go. So guys, next is the ability to write. So going on to the ability to write, I think the Parker and these, both of them are pretty good. I just tested out, I wrote a page of something, a book, yeah, not a book, but I wrote a page of poem, something, and both of them is pretty cool. I didn't find any difference between the writing, they write pretty smooth, pretty cool. So, in the ability to write, both of them I got a point. So, total points are, this pen has 2, this pen has 1. Now finally, we have to see the everywhere use. So if you're a guy who like doesn't take things to school, because it's too costly, why should I take that to school? If you're like that, then this is not a pen for you. Means if you're a guy, okay, I don't care if it gets lost. If you're like that, this is a pen for you. If you're a guy who wants to stay calm and just keep writing on, which is pretty smooth. It means this is not so smooth actually. It writes like a little bit rough. This is pretty smooth. So if you want to use everywhere, and if you're a person who doesn't care any pen in pericardium, I can take anywhere, then this is a pen for you. If you are a person who doesn't want to take costly pens to school or somewhere where you might lose it, this is pen for you. So totally comparison has got equal points. So he has got equal points for the bear. So he has 3 points, and he has, no, this pen has 3 points and this pen has 2 points. So finally, the winner is the Glamatic Vorito. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, smash the like down below. And if you and I'm thanking you guys for the notification squad. If you're not in the notification squad, just subscribe and press the bell icon and comment down below. I'm in the notification squad. Bye guys, have a nice day.